Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this video, I'll show you how to convert Google Sheet data into JSON URL. And it can be used from any programming language like Python or any Android application or any website as an API. There are so many ways to make Google Sheet as a JSON URL, but I will show you the simplest one. And this is very useful. Now in the last video, I have discussed about how you can get the stock data by using Google Finance command. And we just create a table for Nifty 50 stock data. Look at here, first is a symbol, then price open, that is the opening price for today, and high, low, and close, and volume. So I have created a table for Nifty 50 stock, and here, look at here, the first is a symbol, price open, high, low, the same thing here by as an JSON URL. So I convert this table as a JSON URL, and this URL can be called from any programming language like Python or JavaScript or any Android application, and you can easily get the data whatever is available in Google Sheet. And if you just change it, then it will change simultaneously with the URL, and you can access without any delay. So this is very useful for any software or any Android application, whatever you are creating. So let's see how you can make your Google Sheet data as an JSON URL. Now let's go to Tools and go to AppScript editor. Now in AppScript editor, within few lines of code, we can create this table as an JSON URL. So let's see. Now let's rename the project name as NSC data, and we will rename the function as doGet, and we will pass the variable e. Now in this function we will take a variable, that is sheet equal to spreadsheet app dot get active. So it will in the sheet variable we will store the data for this active sheet, that is NSC data. Now here we will take another variable, let me take NSC equal to sheet dot get sheet by name, and the name will be, let me rename the name of the sheet as, let me take NAC in capital, so we have to provide the name of the sheet here, NSE. So in NSC variable we will have the data of NSC sheet. Now if we have multiple sheet here, then we have to mention we have to take another variable, and we have to store the sheet by name of that particular sheet. Now let me create another variable data. In data variable we will store all the data of this sheet, that means all table data, whatever we want to get as a JSON file, so all data will store in data variable. Now let me take a variable of row length, r length equal to NAC dot get last row. That means in r length we will store the value how many rows are there. Similarly, variable c length, in column length we will store NAC dot get last column. And now we will take another variable rows. In rows we will store all rows, that is total data, that is NAC dot get range, and the range will be from first row to the last row. So the range will be 1, 1 up to row length, column length. That is from first, that is first cell, that is A1, is 1-1 position, and column length is F, and row length is, look at here, row length is 55, so F55, from A1 to F55, and dot get values, that is in this statement we will store all the table value into rows variable. Now for variable I equal to 0, I less than rows dot length, and sorry, and I plus plus. Now here we will take another variable data row. Data row equal to rows I. That is in data row we will store ith row in data row. And let me take another variable record equal to, now let me take another for loop to access the element, variable j equal to 1, j less than c length, that is column length, and j plus plus. Now here we will take record, under record we will take rows 0 comma j equal to data row j. Now in this line look at here, in record variable we will store record 0 j, that is 0 means the first row, that is look at here first row, the symbol price open high low price and volume, these are all JSON key, so we will store JSON key corresponding to the JSON data for every row. So here it will fix for every row. Now our program is almost done, so now here we will create the data variable, and we will data dot push record. Now everything is done. In data variable we store all the data of this table. Now let me see whether it's working or not. Let me console dot log, let me print, sorry, data. Let's save the file. Now let's run the file. Now to run the file in the first time you need to give the permission, so we'll give the permission here. Let me select the mail ID and go to the advanced, go to the NSC data, and we have to allow. Now let's run the file and let's view the log. Look at here, the data is coming, first price open and everything is there, so it's okay. Now we will make it as a JSON variable. Let me take a variable result. Result equal to JSON dot stringify object that is data. And we will return content service dot create text output, and we will pass the variable result dot set mime type, and it will be the same as content service dot mime type dot JSON. Now everything is done, so let me save the script and let's publish, and we'll deploy as web app. Now let's deploy as an web app. Now let's go to the JSON file. Look at here. Now look at here, our data table is in JSON format. Look at here, there is no symbol, so we have to check our code. Look at here, in here we have to start I from 1 and j from 0. Let me save this file and let me publish as a web app, and we'll change the version as a new version and we'll update it. Now let's go to the code. Now look at here. Now it's fine. The first stock name is Adani Ports. Look at here, Adani Ports, and it is a price open 792 and everything here. Now if we add any other column, let me add this signal, and we'll take just one, two like that, and we'll copy. So here we are creating a new column. Let me see whether the column is updated here or not. Now let's reload the page. Look at here, the signal column has come here. Now if we change here to 100, and it will change here. So it's a simultaneous act. So if you change any data here, you will get it here at that time. So there is no delay. So here we have created a JSON URL for our data. So now we are going to fetch the data from Python. Let me open a Python terminal, and let me, now I am in example.py file. So let me import request, and let me take a variable data is equal to request dot get URL. Let me store it as URL equal to, let me paste the URL, sorry, now this dot JSON, and let me print. Now save this file and let's run the file. Oops, there is a problem. Now here we cannot access this URL from Python because we didn't give the permission to anonymous. So let me go to the Chrome, and let me go to the Google script, and let's deploy it. Now look at here, who can access the app? only myself. Here we need to change it anyone, even anonymous. Then we can access from any other programming language. Now it is updated. Let's check here whether it's working or not. Now let's try to import. Look at here. Now the data is in a JSON format, so let me take a pandas data frame, then we'll understand the data in old manner. Let me print the data as pd.dataframe, and let's run the file and we'll get it as a table. Look at here. Look at here, Adani port 792 and our signal is 100. Now if we change here the signal is 100 to, let me take 2000. Now look at here. Now let's see whether it, look at here, the signal is 2000, so it's changed simultaneously. So whenever you have created some database or some screener, and it will get the data in Google Sheet, as well as if you try to make it as a JSON array, and if you want to fetch the data from anywhere, from Python or JavaScript or Android application, you will get it without any delay. So in this way you can create a Google Sheet as a JSON URL, and you can access from anywhere, any your programming language, any programming language, and this is very useful tool for to develop any website or to create any software in Python or C or C++, any programming language. So that's it for today. Hope you like my videos. If you like my videos, then please subscribe my channel and please be with me. And thank you, and thanks for watching me.